What's up, YouTube? That's first things first. Let's see what we got here. The chop shop. Complete all salvage yard robberies. One of five, and there's only three available. What does that mean? This is drip feed. This is the new way that Rockstar does their businesses. Rather than releasing everything day one, the Netflix style, they're releasing things in a drip feed, the every other streaming service style. And we'll get more missions as weeks progress. It's their way of extending the excitement and trying to maintain a player base. Every time a new mission comes in, they expect the people to come back because they want to play it. So I will. I'll point something out that I noticed yesterday in a minute. That also tells you that more things are coming. Let's see. So five vehicles in perfect condition from salvage yard robberies. I got one of five. I will have three of five when it's all said and done. Complete all bonus challenges for a salvage yard robbery. Oh my god, that's gonna be hard. Because I don't know all the bonuses and I didn't look it up. Not my style to do that. Unless I actually have to. Speaking of not looking something up, but something did come across my Google. There are missions in this DLC that people may or may not know about. You may have gotten an email not too long ago if you've been playing the new DLC talking about West Coast Classics having its 10-year anniversary. And a call now for your chance to win something. And I was wondering what that was about, but out of sight, out of mind, I kind of forgot about it. And then I came across my Google feed the other day that that's a start to a mission with DJ Pooh, people may or may not know about. And there's a number, I guess the number's supposed to be in the email, although the email hasn't come. We'll see if it comes or not. If it doesn't, I do have a number. And in fairness, I did say that I don't look things up. I did not look this up, it just came across my feed. And I was like, oh yeah, that West Coast Classics email that came across my screen that I didn't read the full email because, whenever somebody sends me something in this game, I usually just forget about it. So many things that come across your feed in the games, and it's just, sometimes information overload, people calling you don't want calling you, tasks to do that. You just X out of English Dave. Oh my god, I hate English Dave. Hear one more time about the kind music needing pizza on Coyote Rico. I did do the first heist, the Omaggio. I only got one of the four targets. I could have very easily gotten three out of four had I known what I was aiming for, though. So, like doing the robbery in under 3 minutes, very capable of doing that. Not killing the police, I was obviously very capable of doing that. I only killed like two police officers, and I was just to take their police cruiser. I could have just as easily tased them had I know. There's a third one. I did get, I don't remember the one I got, but it was the easiest one, I guess, because, you know, I got it without even trying. Oh, so busy talking, I wasn't paying attention to that. So yeah, it says for the third tier that I have to get a perfect robbery, which means I have to do all four tasks. Not impossible, once you know me. Now that I do know that, though, although I did not look up the previous one, I am going to have to look up the finale of this one. I don't want to, but I do want that tier 4. The more tier 4s I have, the closer I get to... I'm thinking like a clothing for it, but it's whatever. I want it. What I really want, most of all, though, is whatever weird car they're going to give us for the tier 4, which I haven't even looked at. I'm pretty sure to do the tier 4, it's going to require you to do all the robberies perfect. So, they usually give you something in tier 3 that says do one of something, and then tier 4 says do all of something. So, you know, I didn't read tier 4, I'm fairly certain it's going to be do all robberies perfect. I'm sure it also has something to do with these tow truck cars I'm doing. Something like steal 500 of them or something crazy. And the tier 4s are always like ridiculous in the amounts of things I want you to do. A tow truck driver.
Almost here? Nice! We can get the car ready to be disassembled, which means payment won't be far behind.
I was playing yesterday, and, ooh, towed away, I got an award. I was playing yesterday and I had this red overalls on and the hat, the tier 1 and tier 2 prizes for Chop Chop. And I walked out of a business and took all my clothing off. All I was wearing was, I don't think I was wearing a shirt, and I was just wearing pants. Funny part about it is that that glitch is also happening right now in NBA 2K, which is another it's under the Take-Two umbrella. Take-Two owns Rockstar, and they also own 2K Sports. So it's funny that it's happening in both of their major games, where they just undress you when you leave a building for some reason. So I was wearing it forward, now I'm wearing it backwards. Ooh, look at me. Anyway, I changed my toe outfit. Totally forgot to change back. I meant to do that when I spawned in. Totally forgot about it. Let's roll. Sweatbox outfit I was just wearing when I spawned in, that was the outfit I bought for the contract DLC, Dr. Dre. I do believe that that was up in the Record A Studios. They have a little store to buy things in. So I have yet to be outside, besides for a mission, so I think once I actually walk outside of Red's the other body shop, I should get the message shortly after. We'll wait and see. We'll try to do it that way rather than looking online. That'd be great if it was one of these cars parked right here. But no, I gotta put it in here. So there's usually like it feels like it's a 1 in 2 chance that you're gonna get the cops on you. Something tells me there's gonna be one of the cop missions. Like, I've done this one before and it was a cop mission, so. Well? Gosh. West. Oh shit. Immersion. Okay, now we got the tow truck lights on. Immersion. Total immersion into the roleplay. Thank you. I love the fact that this mission's all downhill and tow truck. That's great. Makes you wonder, like, people in San Francisco, how they do with the tow. I mean, I guess, I don't know. Driving down steep hills, I can't imagine that the truck doesn't, or the car doesn't try to hit the truck when you're on a deep slant, you know, downhill. How do you counter that? There's gotta be a way. But this happened where I take sudden stops here. I'm not gonna do it because I still don't know the extent that the
We can get the car ready to be disassembled, which means payment won't be.
I don't know the extent of doing damage to these cars does to your reduction in your profits, so. But when you slam on the brakes pretty hard, that car does wham into your tow truck, the car behind you. When you're towing one. And we're done. I like to see how much money I make for a day, so I usually deposit before I start going to make money. I obviously made $201,500. Actually, I think I made more. I think I banked, and then I decided to stay on a little bit longer, so that's a second bank. I definitely made more, actually. You have forgotten about
me. What's up with you?
What's up with you? I definitely made more yesterday, because I decided, since I'm about to start spending big money on the cop cars, that I need a little more money, so I went and moved some products. Moved my meth, moved my counterfeit cash. First time in a long time. Did it by myself in a public lobby, full lobby. Got 1.5 times money for it. My cocaine wasn't quite done, but I'm sure it's done now. Maybe I'll move that later. I don't know, we'll see. It's there. But I could actually start opening a motorcycle club now again, because I only have the weed and coke. Odds are they're not gonna like constantly raid me if I only have two businesses. Only one of them's full too. I think the other one isn't quite full. I don't know. But as you can see, slowly all the day's stuff is trickling in, so I'm gonna wait and see if this one. DJ Pooh, West Coast Classics email comes through. That's the biggest thing. I mean, I'm afraid if I go indoors. Trash. Care about your pay-to-win mechanics, Rockstar? GTA Plus. More like GTA Sus. I burned Rockstar with that one.
the Diamond Casino and Resort. Fight the evil of boredom with high-stakes gaming. Rich people truly are happier.
I'm guessing you don't want a back rub. How can I help? Okay, I'll get you out of trouble. No problem.
So I recently saw that in order to do a level 4 thing, I gotta steal some simian cars and give them to them, which I never do, which is why it's one of the things that I have to check off. So yeah, I saw that Sentinel, because I just saw it, and Simeon just sent me the list for the day, and the Sentinel was on it. So I was chasing out that Sentinel, and it just got away from me, and just as it did, I saw this car. I'm like, wait a minute, I need that car too. So I took this one. I was about to run back to my oppressor and really just destroy that Sentinel for running away from me, but we'll do this. So the key here is to not do any damage to the car. I don't remember, so a lot of old GTA stuff, like this is an OG GTA Online thing. This is something that people did back in 2013, 2014, like when the game first came out. As such, it never paid well. It wasn't worth your time. Especially as as inflation started hitting the economy in GTA, and now you have to pay $5 million for a body shop that really doesn't pay off $5 million in return. So I don't remember if they started upping the rates on these, but usually you only got like $4,000 to $5,000 for a car. Not a lot. I gotta go to the docks and deliver the vehicle to Sam, yeah. And you have to not hit a car, because it gives you less money if you do. So I remember, like, the first few times I did this, I only got, like, 4,000 a car, 3,000 a car. I was like, forget this, I'm not doing it anymore. So I just stopped. And like about 2 years ago, they changed the economy in the game. They started, I mean, lately they've started screwing with the prices of cars and things like that, but they changed some things that were not paying off, old GTA Online things that didn't catch up to the economy, and as a result, nobody was playing them anymore, like races. There were a lot of races that people weren't playing anymore, so the payout for like the winner was so like little that it's not worth your time or effort. And God forbid you only come in like 6th or 7th, you're going to get like, you know, $100, like a pat on the back. So they upped a lot of the payouts for old GTA Online content. I wonder if this is going to be one of those games. Or modes, I should say, rather. It's one of those modes. Or if it's just going to be the same. Terrible payout from before, and I'm just gonna do it just so I can get the that much closer to my tier 4 for vehicle enthusiasts. I believe that's the one I'm doing this for. Oh my god, I can't believe I just hit a car. Well, there goes the perfecto. Oh, no, sorry. You know what? Usually when it's 100,000, that's when you want to go and do one of those missions with Marcel, the bouncer. You probably right back up and leave it alone for a couple of days, in-game days, which are like 48 minutes a day. So just wash, rinse, and repeat. Go check periodically to see what you're. Lower levels are crewing the product. It's ready to be sold or not. Chill, dude. Really? I'm glad GTA 6 is coming out soon. Well, if I say soon, it's like a year away at least. Finally fixed the driving. GTA 5 driving is just horrible. Just horrible. What brings you in today? AI has improved so much more over the past 10 years. It's going to be probably a lot better. Yeah, I repaired the vehicle. That's all it was. It's a little ding, but that's all it took. Not injure or incapacitate or scratch or even breathe weird on this car, okay? yourself.
Okay. Looks in good condition. Should pay out nicely.
That's how Simeon. Oh, 20,000. I mean, that's not great, but it's better than the 4,000 they used to give you. So yeah, I was right. They do pay out better. Spawn in front of me, come on. Oops. So I do want that sentinels. There's like 1 million sentinels on the road. Just got nowhere to look for them. They're not spawning over here. They're definitely not spawning down here. You see where all those skyscrapers are? Sentinels to be had out there. I should probably be doing something else, but now I got sentinels on the mind. I just want to get it done. That's the one I definitely remember off that list. I'm not willing to go look at the rest of the list.
Oh my god! Shit! Dark bag? I'm gonna mess you up!
Thank you. gosh. No way.
I'm so scared, I can't even think.
What's happening?
I swear, when I'm not looking for one, there's like 15,000 that pop up. When I do look for one, I can't possibly find one. They're all just not spawning in. Wasn't a coup for... Am I only allowed to give one to a bank? Or I was sending a bank? It's a Sentinel. I think it might have said Sentinel RS. I don't know, we're gonna find out once I'm just a cop, so. Oops. All this crap. Mm-hmm. this sucks. If I could do more than one. I just wasted a lot of time for nothing. I do have an idea, though, for future. I'm gonna have to deal with this again. Had the penthouse, the most expensive penthouse. It was one of the first purchases I made in the game, thinking that an apartment was very important in this game. Turns out it wasn't. I mean, it's important for the original heist, but you could do it with any moderate apartment. You don't need the most expensive one. So I spent well over $1 million, and for back then, first off, $1 million was a lot in this game. But second, it took me forever to save it, and then I was broke as a result. So I had the most expensive apartment, but I'm driving around like, as a matter of fact, I think Sentinel, I stole Sentinel, and that was my personal vehicle. I made it my personal vehicle. Oh, this is not the apartment. This is not the garage. Alright. I'll tell the story in a minute when I find a proper garage. I was a poor boy living in a rich apartment, and it's usually, like, you know, reserved for people that actually have money in this game, which I did not. I got my first, and then I started saving up $2 million to get that business over there, the CEO office. I got in the, Arcadius building. I just wanted to be different than everybody else. I didn't want to get the cheap one. I wanted to get the slightly more expensive one. Well, slightly more expensive. The cheapest CEO was $1 million. That was $2 million. So, and for a broke boy, that took a long time to save up on. But I finally got there. And when I did get there, though, I couldn't afford the sleeping quarters. My friend, he had sleeping quarters in his, so he could spawn into his CO. I could not. So I had an idea where I could make myself a little bit of money and actually buy myself a decent car. So up until then, I was driving a really lousy car. Doesn't matter, actually. It's a little parking, so I don't have to do damage to me. I parked the car. I'm sorry. I sold my $1 million apartment and bought the one I currently own for $400,000 right across the street from the Arcadius. So rather than spawning into my CO building, instead of spawning into my CEO office, I spawned into the apartment across the street, and then I just had to park across the street. It was a cheap way of not having to pay the additional money that I did not have for sleeping quarters. And I actually made money off of it, because when you trade like I did, to get the money back for the penthouse. But I had to, in order to, you can't just sell a building that you own. Wait, where's the entrance for this thing? Tells me off my coin. You can't just sell an apartment or a garage. You can trade for a cheaper version and get the money back on the difference. So that's what I did. I traded for, I already owned the cheapest property in the game. It was a two-car garage in Sandy Shores. That's where I was spawning forever until I finally could afford the apartment in the city. So I got the second cheapest property in the game, which is this one. So I get the max amount in trade value. Here we are. I actually have a purpose for this thing. I've come here maybe once just to check it out. It's the same looking as the Sandy Shores one in the interior, you know, nothing different. You got your computer here so you can go on the internet. I guess that was before the phones had internet. Change the radio here. You could get on this thing, right? You could. Whoa. I'm a wizard. And then you just, you know. Like, I would wait in here for my friend to come and pick me up because I didn't really have any cars at the time, and he had all the fast cars. So I'd be spawning in here, and then I'd have to wait for him to drive from the city all the way out to Sandy Shores to come get me. So I saw... I saw, like, every little bit of this thing. There's nothing to see here. That's my point. However, now I have a sentinel in there. Stock that away. Next time I have to look for a simian vehicle and sentinel's one of them, I can very easily utilize. I gotta buy a BMX bike. I always forget to buy one. I need to buy a BMX bike and come over here and ride. Alright. Just gonna pretend that we saw it.
Hello, chum. Now here's your old friend indeed here. Now Carter music looked to be about two tempo shifts away from a serious wobbly. We need the big guns flown out here right away. My personal chakra stones. Can you make it happen? Oh, you're a diamond. Now, my mainland shaman lives in an intentional community up in a desert.
I didn't mean to press that
button. He was supposed to bless the stones, but he's only gone and nicked them. Oh, I blame too much root and not enough stem. Anyway, okay, all bits are that. Off. Get him however you need to.
just press through that. I was just kind of curious what he, what his request was. Normally I just hang right up on him. You got me on this one. I don't know. Maybe if you do these enough, he'll stop calling you, right? Probably not. I mean, I could just skip to another lobby, but... DJ Pooh's music stick. But no. What started as a Chop Shop DLC run has turned into a coyote thing. There's multiple shops. Oh no, it's the cops.
Now I don't mean to alarm you, but unless I'm very much mistaken, we've got a bad energy front coming in fast over here. If I don't get no stones pretty lively, I could go under.
Me to go to pretty sure.
You don't want to mess around with that kind of conduit, yeah?
I've never done this mission before. I've done the pizza one. We have to... They have the munchies and I have to get the pizza. Gotten some chakra.
I sense help is on the way. Oh, just in the nick of. You saved old Davey once again. And, kind of music, too, of course.
Take me to the island. Why can't I just fly there myself on my freaking rocket with a saddle? That was the last one? Huh. I was at 6 or 7 forever. I didn't know that this was part of it. I always thought it was Tom Connors. I did all the Tom Connors ones a long time ago.
Hello, sailor. Dave here. Listen, you've pulled all the stops for us over here. And don't think it's gone unnoticed. Now, I'd like you to take my motor for keeps. Genuinely attachments in it. And today, my loss is your gain. Piece of bloody history there. Keys are inside. You are welcome.
What? I didn't know any of this was a thing. Alright, I guess I'll explain. I had noticed this a while back. I had 6 out of 7 complete all DJ requests for Tom Connors in English State. There were 5 different missions I had to do for Tom Connors. And I always said like 6 or 7 or something like that. So I assumed that I was always missing out on the one Tom Connor mission. I never even noticed the English Dave part. I did tell you I did one of English Dave's missions, the pizza one before, but I never did this one. This man called me a million times to do these stupid missions. And I always just hung up the phone on him because I hate English Dave. And it turns out he's been trying to tell me this all along. Hey, do this for me. And the reason why, I guess, is by doing it. Which I did, again, I just did by accident. I pressed the button by accident. I didn't mean to do it. But I did. I guess. Alright. Oh, so I did that already. But I thought that other thing... I don't know. I never saw the English Dave part on that other thing. I guess now I just finished this. Oh, wait, no, I did that too. Oh, God. I guess I just finished that without realizing it. I gotta do that. I gotta knock that off. I am here. I should do it while I'm here. I think 10 of them means you have to come back 5 days. I think you only get 2 treasure chests a day. I just don't feel like it right now. Besides, I don't know where they are. I'd have to look it up and stuff. Alright, let's see, get me back. I'm ready to go now. Let's see what card English Dave gave me. I didn't even know this was a thing. This was a happy surprise. I was trying to do a secret mission for, DJ Pooh, and instead I'm doing a secret mission for English Dave. I love when Rockstar is cryptic when they give you shit. Like, they did the same thing with Dr. Freelander's car and the Drug Wars DLC. Like, it's gotta be somewhere on this map. I just have to go find it. So 15,000 things on the map. And this is with half the shit turned off. Imagine. Imagine a new player coming in and trying to figure out heads or tails to this stuff. I don't know. Winky. I saw Winky on the map, but that Winky is a... It's that Jeep that I got in to get back to off Cairo-Pirito. So I don't know. I can get in now. I don't want to watch a YouTube video. Can you just tell me where it is? Are you losing BF Weevil cards valued at $850,000 I bought? Tells me he left it for me. But where? Where did he leave it for me? car. Harper. I was there. What?
Thank you.
$850,000 car, which, by the way, I already own. But the one I have is a Benny's one, not an original one, so I wouldn't mind having an original one. Oh, wait a minute. This... Okay. Did I, like, fly over it, or is it just not spawning? According to this picture, it should be right here. It's not. Did I see something? Thoroughly annoyed right now. Give me my car. I'm going to assume I need a new lobby. That's the problem. Easy. There we go. Some Sometimes Rockstar's a little funky with their stuff. So, and look at that, it's right on the map too. I'm gonna look for it. Oh no, Dr. Dre! Every day is Dre Day in GTA. Hey. Is love. Where do I put it? Oh man, there's no jump here, really? Jump on the other one. I thought English Dave missions were just never-ending missions that were just ways to get you to go back to Cayo Perico. Like, he would just call you non-stop. According to this video I watched to see what the deal is with this car just now. Just like I said, I didn't know before. Well, once it didn't spawn in, I had to figure out where it was. It says Dave won't call you anymore. That's it. No more Dave. I don't know if I'm gonna miss his calls or not. He's literally called me hundreds, hundreds, like 400 or 500 times. 300, 200, 400, I don't know. Every time I got out of the game for years now, since Kyoprika. It's been hundreds. I would say 200 or 300. It. This garage is full. My 50 car garage is full. So that's another. It's well over 100 cars. Easy. Once I got other cars in other places. So it's getting kind of full. Where did I put? Yeah, we. No, we already did that. We don't want to upgrade this one to Benny's. This one's going to be our regular Weevil.
Makes sense in these troubled times, I guess.
We're going to pair it with the Benny's Weevil. We did that to the other one. We took off its rear thing. We already ugled up the other one. This one, I just want to make it just plain old school bug. Minus the bumpers, I guess.
Whatever you desire. Technology is money.
The love machine. E. Cola and Sprunk. Actually, the Sprunk one actually matches it. Okay, so we get E-colons from license plates, I guess. That's a thing now. Oh, roll cage. Just not overly interested in changing its look. I'm not going to be driving around a lot.
If you can think it, I can do it. This turbo should help us safety. Yes, it did. Good luck blowing those.
Look at that bad boy. That's a bad boy. That's cool. A mysterious car that I never knew was even available for free. Oh wait. There's the Weevil. This is the Benny's version of the Weevil. It came out not this Halloween, but the previous Halloween. So, in honor of that Halloween, I upgraded it to a Death Weevil. As you can see, it has its engine on, showing out the back. I put the roll bar on the back. The crazy extension thing here with the Benny's. I put the little spikes on the top. I put the skull. Inside. Let's see how I go. Oh, where's the shifter? If you can see the shifter, it's a suicide shifter with like a skull, I'm pretty sure. Because I went skull with this one. But yeah, this was my Benny's modification, my big. Cost a lot of money to do a Benny's car. The deal with this car? I think this is like one of the new cars. Why is it running away in here? I I'm gonna have to come back for that car. That car is one of the new cars. Oh, I don't have to do this anymore. I don't have to drive cars to different places anymore. There's supposedly a new way of doing things. Moving cars that you don't want to have to move on your own. We're going to test that out now. Another new Chup Chup DLC exclusive. You know what?
Boss.
Hello.
Hello. What can I do for you? How do you choose between your children? Your personal vehicle is being brought up now.
These are even calling me when I get down there. What the deity looks like. Good enough. I like the virtue where it is now, actually. That's his permanent home. Even though it doesn't have to be, it was part of the 50 car garage until I started doing some security contracts and I needed a car that could not be detected by. I needed a car that couldn't be locked onto. I needed a Monitech car. So I use the Virtue, because I like driving it. That way, whenever I was in a public lobby and I was doing security contracts, I wouldn't get griefed while I was trying to bring product back to the agency, whether it was valuables or cars or whatever they had me stealing. Franklin and his legitimate business. Like Simeon. He's a legitimate businessman. I don't know what Dark Riker says. Alright. cares? How do you make a phone call on this thing? Oh, West Coast Glasses, sorry, on my thing.
You just got through the West Coast Classics. Ain't nothing like finding a mixtape with some dang funky. Somewhere on a porch out there on Grove Street. Go get it.
Okay. So anyway, like I said, he sent me an email saying, hey, it's 10th anniversary, call in. And they put the thing in my phone. So now I just gotta go. Grove Street. Nothing to see here, guys. Just, body shop guy just doing body shop things. Can't pet that dog. Can't pet that dog. I cannot pet that dog. I'm just chilling. So anyway, so I saw, I read the thing, I didn't see anything, so I don't know where this thing is. It's a music stick, I'm sure it'll stick out once I get close to it. I'm chilling, guys. Damn, Funk.
This is Holland, fuck you. No shot. Oh shit. Well, the dog got me. Damn it, I should have just got on the thing and just ripped them up with the oppressor. Anyway. Got the stick. Go back to Grove Street, pick up my whip. My whip. I don't recognize shit. So this is the result that I got. Oh, actually, so probably to play the rights to play the stick. So I got a bunch of different sticks. I got, when the contract came out, there were a bunch of different sticks, extra, all the whole Dre album, some extra songs. Some preferences.
Kenny's Backyard Boogie, CLR Launch Party, on Dre, Let's Get It, Even Score, Blue EP, Green EP, Wild EP. Obviously, I've gotten a lot of sticks. I got the Dre sticks, I got these different EPs, I remember those. I don't know what Kenny's Backyard Boogie is. I don't know what CLR's Launch Party is. Circle Loco Records, CLR Launch Party, Moody Man. Okay, so let's. I think this is the one. Okay. I hate when you press triangle and it doesn't land. I really do. It's not like I wasn't close enough to the ground. I just don't get that sometimes. I don't want to drive this guy, but I need to. I much prefer the ones where I just throw somebody out of the club, but... Your chariot awaits.
Marcel tells me you're our resident humanitarian. Well, you couldn't have chosen a better recipient for your kindness. This guy's a lawyer for the Duggins. Maybe he'll give us a discount on my friggin' gas. Here's his address. Get him home.
I hate these long ones too, this takes forever.
You know, I kind of missed the times when it was hedge fund managers and D-grade celebrities we had to scrape off the floor of the VIP lounge. Now, with these gas prices, the freaking oil tycoons are back in style. And I mean, there's assholes and there's assholes, you know? And oil and gas people are definitely assholes.